nothing about birthing babies.
That is a clip from the famed movie Gone with the Wind. The Orpheum announced this week it would not be showing the film due to its depictions of race and slavery in the Civil War era South. While many applauded the theater's decision, some reacted in anger and even made some threats. Theater operators said in a statement, "As an organization whose stated mission is to entertain, educate, and enlighten the communities it serves, the Orpheum cannot show a film that is insensitive to a large segment of its population." Now, we asked Brett Batterson, CEO of the Orpheum, to join us tonight, but we were told that he would not be answering any other questions on the subject, but these two will. So, Otis, I'm not aware of any other time where this movie has been banned in Memphis. Do you think that he made the right decision on this?
Well, I think he made the decision that was best for his organization. The movie is really not banned in Memphis. If people want to find a way to go see Gone with the Wind, they can find a way to go
see
Gone with the Wind.
Sure, they can go to Redbox and they can pick it up and watch it.
Absolutely, or wherever you want to find it. So it's not like, you know, I'm a history buff, as you are. There was a time when we had a guy in town by the name of Lloyd T. Benford, who was the censor in town. He banned movies and plays. We're not talking about banning anything.
Well, would you have pulled this from the Orpheum Theater lineup?
Actually, yes. Because I think, you know, I'm trying to put myself into the shoes of someone who depends on patrons for the livelihood, and I understand that he probably upset a lot of his patrons, so he hesitated, I'm sure. So that's why I did. But I would have done it because times change, and we have to change with the times. And we've seen all of the recent events. It's just time to move on from the kind of racism that this movie depicts. I've seen the movie several times. From a cinematic standpoint, it's a good cinematic movie, but it is racist and it's offensive. And for a city like Memphis, yes, the Orpheum did the right thing. People can go see it somewhere else.
Councilman, was it the right decision, even if the opinion is universal?
I think it was the right decision. I mean, I think the people that go to see this movie, they're going to see a film classic. They're going to see a movie that won a lot of Oscars, including the first African American to win an Oscar. But at the same time, historically, it is insultingly inaccurate. But the only thing it got right was that there was slavery in Atlanta fell. Everything else was completely wrong. So I think in 2017 in Memphis, to be a progressive city, to move forward like this, something that serves no real true historical purpose, it's time to go.
Is it censorship?
I don't think so, because you can see it anywhere you want to see it. But again, the Orpheum, they're a nonprofit. So they live and die by contribution. So their decision obviously was made in the best interest of the Orpheum. But I also think they were being a community player. People can go see it if they wish to, but just not there.
Some of the critics are saying, where do you draw the line on freedom of expression? Are there other things that should be forbidden from people seeing? Mark Twain was an American author, a classic, but right, many of his classics included a lot of racist tones.
Oh, no question about it.
Should we start banning the books?
Well, as a matter of fact,
forbidding our kids from watching from reading the books in 2017.
Well, about 6 or 7 years ago, there was an effort by some professors to sanitize the Huckleberry Finn Mark Twain
and
book.
Tom Sawyer.
I was against that. I mean, we're talking about books in the era, and people, you know, a book is not in your face like the movie would be. So people can go get the book if they want to get the book. I'm a First Amendment guy, but I do understand that there are times when times change, and in an entity like the Orpheum, they're making a decision based on what's going on in the country right now. They're making a decision based on the people who live here in the city of Memphis. And it is time out for that kind of racial oppression that Gone with the Wind shows.
Councilman, is this a product of the Confederate statue debate as well, do you think?
That's where I was going. I think there's a place in historical context for everything. Churchill taught us those who forget history are condemned condemned to repeat it. And I think that's a very important point, that we can't burn books and we can't just get rid of things because they offend us. There is a historical context for these things and in the correct place. So it does tie directly to the statues. It's in the same genre. And because of Charlottesville, I think it does also promote a healthy discussion as to where perhaps these things should be shown, where perhaps these statues should go.
Critics would also argue that with the statues, that's in a public place where in full view of everyone. The Orpheum is a paid venue where they're actually paying to actually see this.
Right.
Is there any difference there?
Well, I see a difference because, again, the parks are publicly financed. My tax dollars are going to keep Jefferson Davis and Nathan Bedford Forrest, the grounds around it, pristine. So, that's a public place. It's an in-your-face place. Those statues need to be somewhere else, where it's Shiloh or some museum. But again, the Orpheum, that's a private entity. It's nonprofit, but it's a private entity, and people pay their money to go see it. It's totally different to me.
And I think that sends the right signal to the community as a whole of what should be in its context and in its place, and then what would be more appropriate, for example, at the Orpheum. So I think that's our takeaway.